Greetings, brothers and sisters. I'm Professor Spira, and out here in my lovely backyard, getting a little bit of sun yet again today. And today's message is, don't be hard on yourself. I constantly say it, and if you go back in all my videos, I probably almost say it in every video, at least when we're talking about diet or the transition, the mucusless diet healing system. Don't be hard on yourself. You know, now yesterday's message was get out of your own head. And then if you are in your head, still try not to be hard on yourself. And what I've come to realize is there are a lot of people that are interested in the mucus-free diet healing system or interested in health and transitioning that have, some self-esteem challenges where they might not really think that they're great or really love themselves. They might love other people, you know, their family or their children, but when they look in the mirror, they don't really have an unconditional love for themselves. Or they look in the mirror and they have this image of what they think they should be like. And this image is something that has been constructed, that they've created in their head based upon societal expectations and media and all this kind of influences that we've been drilled with since childhood. And so we get this constructed image in our head of what we think we should be like, and we look in the mirror and we don't see ourselves living up to that, and then we think that we are not good enough, or we don't measure up to this this fantasy that we've created in our head. And that can create negative emotions and depression and all these kind of things, anxieties, and ultimately comes down to then, being real hard on yourself. Within the mucus-free diet, a lot of people are under the misinterpretation or misunderstanding that you have to, that you have to get toward this ultimate goal as fast as you can. That you gotta be mucus free today. You gotta be totally mucus free, and anytime you're not mucus free, you are not living up again to this fantasy image that you've created. That that is not really a healthy image of what is possible. And I say that a lot to the folks that are trying to do the all fruit things without any transition, and a lot of the raw vegans. I kind of have that message to them, but they don't want to hear me until they fall off the ladder, and then sometimes they'll they'll reach back out and be like, I see what you were saying, but it's too late. If you could heed the message now, I'm saying don't worry about that. This is not about perfection in terms of your practice, because there's no such thing as a perfect practice of the mucus-free diet healing system, because each person's practice is going to be incredibly different. So in terms of living up to something, you don't have to try to live up to my image or Brother Ayer's image or anybody else's image of what a mucus-free diet practitioner is or should be, or live up to things that you've heard us talk about. And that's one of the challenges, the really profound challenges of sharing the mucus-free diet healing system lifestyle, is everybody is in very different stages. And if you talk about your experience at a particular stage, it will resonate with a number of people, but it's also could be misunderstood or misconstrued by other people that cannot yet interpret or really understand the experiences that you're trying to explain or that you are going through right now. And that is, yes, that's just a real challenge. You know, how can you share the lifestyle when what you are doing within the context of a transition could be just taken so out of context and so misunderstood? But with that said, you know, I mean, this whole piece has been getting me to kind of study self-esteem a bit, because I've always come to this issue from a different place than I think maybe a lot of people that struggle with self-esteem are in a different situation than I ever was. You know, I was talking to Brother Air earlier today, and you know, he said he never had that type of issue. So I need help understanding better and knowing how to better communicate to folks that might really be in their head and really have a negative self-image. Because I want you to look in the mirror and have love. There's a difference between, you have to have love and be honest with yourself at the same time. And because it's not about looking in the mirror and then being fake. Because we can't abide by that, you know, where you're looking at, where you look, you know, and oftentimes if it is fake, that's just covering up the real hatred toward oneself. Because if you're looking in the mirror and you have to do these, it's like the self affirmations. You know, I don't, maybe it helps some people. I'm not just gonna like trash it, but to me, it's like putting a cover over the problem. So you can sort of go through a mantra looking in the mirror like, I'm good enough, I'm smart enough, and doggone it, people like me. I mean, you can, you know, y'all that know the reference to the SNL skit there, but, you know, that there's that sort of the so-called positive thinking. You know, I've just never been particularly impressed with that form of self-help. I think there's a lot of better systems and better approaches to actually confronting the issues and then working through them and getting to a place of real peace, love, and understanding for oneself and for the other people around you, and a real compassion for yourself and others. But you got to work for that. With the case for me, and you know, because I've done a lot of self-help and a lot of things in that, and so there's, you know, areas where I've really sharpened my tools on that. And I had self-consciousness growing up about being overweight, but I never thought that I wasn't worthy. You know, I didn't have a low self-worth. I'm really guilty. I mean, I felt bad because people were making fun of me, and you know, I wanted belonging, and I wanted to, you know, that kind of thing. So that's, you know, a little self-esteem related stuff, but it's not what I'm seeing with where people are taking something like Mucus's diet and they're creating this sort of unrealistic expectations in their head about how fast they should be able to do it. And that if they don't reach their goal within a particular period of time that they've created in their head, that they are not good enough, or they're not doing the diet or practicing it or this kind of thing. And so I'm here to say, you know, don't be hard on yourself and do whatever it is you need to do in order to confront any kind of self-esteem issues, because if you don't look in the mirror and have a real true love for yourself, and regardless of whatever you've done, sometimes you gotta forgive yourself. Maybe you did something to somebody, or there's something like that, or you know, there's a lot of reasons that there could be guilt that you're harboring, And you got to deal with that. Now, a lot of ways to deal with it down below or in the blog. If you're on the blog, I'm going to put this video on the blog, and I'm going to put a few links down below to some couple articles, you know, but there's a lot of articles on, if you just Google overcoming self-esteem issues, I mean, there's a lot of stuff written on it and psychology and that kind of stuff. Now, for me, I just strongly recommend Sedona method. I just love that method. If you really, and you go through the audio course, I mean, the book is cool, but if you sit through the hours of the audio course, there's a lot of guided periods of going through the process. But particularly when it comes to self-esteem, there is a lot of learning how to let go of worrying what other people think about you. One of our core beliefs that a lot of people have, or sort of a core desire, is belonging and acceptance. You know, are you accepted by everybody? You know, this issue with, say, the Arnold Arid Forum, of people being scared to post something up because there may be some criticisms, where if you really truly were free and had no fear of who cares what anybody else has to say, if you feel like sharing, share. But why are you sharing? And because when I hear about, like, people might criticize, it's like, well, are you sharing because you want validation from others? And that can be in the form of support. So I'm not saying that's necessarily a bad thing, but I'm saying, let's look at this. Like, why are you sharing? You know, are you sharing because you're trying to get validation from others? Are you sharing because you are, you know, is it an ego trip where you're just trying to, like, show off, like, hey, this is what I'm doing? And sometimes when that happens, that those people don't care about that, you know, or are you sharing as is a totally selfless? You're sharing for the sake of putting something out there that you hope might help one person. I mean, that was my attitude with doing from the beginning when I started the forum. A lot of you know the story of how the forum had like 10 people in it. Nobody was talking, and I started replying to myself. I was basically talking to myself. But once we started getting people in it, my attitude was, even at times when there was a couple times when I thought about, man, maybe I should shut it down, or, you know, there's people really aren't ready, or they're not interested in what I have to share. But then people would start to send me messages where they appreciated what I was doing. And so I wasn't looking for that kind of validation, but once I knew that it was helping somebody, I kind of had the attitude, if I can help one person with everything I do, that I'm not doing for myself. Because there was a point where I wasn't sharing for me to try to learn more, because I'm sharing to try to help people understand something a little bit better. But when it looked like there wasn't going to be too many people that, or even one, you know, one person that really was benefiting from it, then I was like, well, maybe I shouldn't do it. But like I said, then people started appreciating, kind of say, hey, you know, I appreciate it. So I kind of just had this attitude, if I can help one person with anything I do, then I'll keep doing it. You know, I'm not doing it in vain. But I'm not looking for anything in return. And so, you know, when I was doing something like that, it was like, I'm just putting this out there. So if I was on a forum, and I share my practices or a picture of some food or something like that, there's always going to be some people that are trolling you or criticizing you or talking mess. And you got to understand that that's their problem. That's their self-esteem problem, where they have such a low self-worth, possibly, that it's like they feel like picking at somebody. Now there's some people that would legitimately have a concern or a critique I like the word critique. You know, there's criticism, but then there's critique. Critique is a little bit cuter of a word. It's not as strong. You know, when you critique something, it's it's that can be looked at as a constructive type of process. I mean, you can have constructive criticism, but just a critique is more objective and not as severe. But somebody could sort of say, and there's an art to that. I mean, if you're an educator, you're somebody that does work with people a lot of times, you know, you learn how to frame things in such a way where you're not destroying somebody's self-esteem, you know, if you can help it, you know, so you kind of say, positive and trying to say, hey, you know, good, you know, it's good to see that you're doing such and such. However, have you thought about it like this? Or, well, what about this? You know, and if you do see an issue. But if we can get to a point where the self-esteem is on lock, where then you don't care as much about those kind of things. Might it ding your, you know, put a little ding in your armor? Yeah. I mean, we're no one's immune from that unless... I mean, there's a few people that are, but they might have mental issues. We don't get into that. But, you know, sometimes somebody could say something or put something on one of my things, it'd be like a little ding in the arm, and you'd be like, ouch, you know. But you know, part of the Sedona Method piece is you don't try to resist something like that. You feel it. You allow yourself to fully feel the emotion, fully fit, and then you let it go. And the problem with a lot of folks is they're resisting. You know, they're trying to push negative emotions away as opposed to just let it come on with it and then let it go. Learn how to let it go. You know, Sedona Method is my go-to method for that, but there's a lot of other systems and ways to do it. Of course, within psychology, you got your psychologists and counselors, and there's a million self-esteem kind of mastery courses and books and all that kind of stuff. I'm not, it's an area of research and study that I need to look more into and try to better understand so that I can better help people in those kind of situations. But overall, my primary message for everybody is that, you know, you're already great. You know, you're already, you know, in my opinion doesn't matter, you know, but you're already, we've been given a gift of this information that very few people on this planet have in 2016. You know, and what you do with the information, what you do with the gift, that's up to you. But I'm just real happy that I've had access to Arnold Eric's Mucus-free Diet Healing System, and that with all of its pros and cons and the good, the bad, and the ugly that's up in it, the positive things that it's brought to my life just outweigh any kind of negative things that happen along the way, you know, periods of a little bit of pain and things that, you know, eliminations and things you're going through and all that kind of stuff. I don't dwell on those things, you know. I'm not dwelling on and fixated on some elimination that I had 5 or 6 years ago. You know, you go through it. You deal with it in the moment, like, oh man, you know, you go through it, but you keep going. You don't keep on fixating on it and worrying about it or worrying that it'll happen again. You know, if you went through something that was kind of tough, if you have a fear of that thing happening again or you going through an elimination like that again, that's a surefire way that it will happen again, because you got to let that go. You know, you got to let that fear go. Within a Sedona type of methodology, you focus on that emotion and that fear, and you let yourself feel it, and then there's a process that you kind of go through that you learn within the course, that just sort of a series of questions you ask yourself that kind of suggests and allows you to let go of that fear, that emotion. And you can do that with anything. I mean, maybe you have a fear of spiders, you know, and so you imagine that experience of you confronting a spider, and all that fear and all that anxiety that you normally push down, you let it come to the surface, but then you take yourself through this process and you do it enough times. You know, if you spend 30 minutes a day on releasing on your worst fear, you can overcome that fear in a relatively short period of time. At least that's been my experience. So the more that you get into something like that, you know, letting go of, you know, the more you let go, the more compassionate and empathetic you can become. So when you're letting go, it's not like you're becoming less caring. You're actually becoming more caring. So if you let go of, say, if a family situation where you are wanting acceptance, look at the word want, which implies that you don't have it. But it's okay that you feel like that. Allow that to come to the surface. Allow the emotions associated with you wanting love from somebody, or you're a family member, or somebody that you respect. Allow that wanting energy to come into your awareness, and then, you know, could you let it go? And would you let it go? When? You know, when would you let that emotion go? You know, you take yourself through a process and you do that. Like, the first time you do it, it's not going to totally go away, but you keep kind of doing that, and you notice that you feel differently about whatever it is that you were fixated on. And so within, you know, Mucus's diet world, say you do a post in the forum and you're sharing a meal. You know, you're sharing, so you're sharing a picture of a mucus lean meal, and somebody comes along and they say something critical about it. And they're like, you probably shouldn't be eating such and such or something like that. Now, a lot of people wouldn't care, you know, it's like, whatever. It's, all right, you know, well, when you eat your meal, then you do what you want to do. I'm doing what I'm going to do, and that kind of thing. But if you're, you know, legitimately, maybe that, you know, maybe that hurts you a little bit, where they're like, ah, man. And then you don't feel like posting again. But what I would suggest would be to allow yourself to really feel that, like, because why is that? Because we should, one of my goals is a certain level of fearlessness in terms of not worrying about what people think about me and all that kind of stuff. That's a maybe that might be your thing, but that, for me, that's a personal goal of freedom. There's a freedom in that. Freedom of not worrying about what people think about you. And it's not that you become totally unaware or cold or cut off. It's just that when somebody throws something at you, you are able to process it differently so that it doesn't harm you, so that 5 years from now, you're still not going through and thinking about, you know, having vengeful thoughts. You know, that one of the things that's taught in a lot of the major religious traditions is to let go of vengeance. Don't be vengeful and hold on, because that hurts you more than it hurts this person that you might not even be associated with. You're sitting here hating somebody and they don't even know you, you know, half the time, you know, they don't even know you. You're like, when people hate people on TV and celebrities and stuff, it's like, you writing all this nasty stuff on their Twitter, that doesn't hurt. They don't know you. It doesn't hurt their feelings. You know, you're fixated on it. So what I'm saying is, we have a tool. Don't feel guilty about having that issue. We have a tool where once you observe that is a problem, and that you need to deal with those kind of emotions, you will know how to let it go. And so that's the thing. And so you gotta let go of feeling guilty for yourself, or feeling sorry for yourself, or, you know, feeling guilty about whatever. You know, you eat some mucus or whatever. Like Brother Air said, about 10, you know, over 10 years into the diet, because Brother Air's transition was relatively slow, you know, but I'm saying that's a good thing. He didn't start off doing long fast and all those kind of things. What he does now is a result of him doing a slow transition, where for 10, 15 years, you know, there was different periods of time where people might just consider it, you know, sort of a vegan type of diet, you know, but he still was applying the system. It wasn't just like, you know, things like there's always a raw salad. You know, he was still doing enemas through the whole process. But it wasn't like he was, you know, practiced for a couple years, Mucus's diet for a couple years, and then he's being mucusless for the next 15, 20 years, like where he's totally mucusless. The mucus lean and mucus free and days of fasting, it's a system. And so he'll probably talk about this next time we talk, but there sometimes he gets the question where people ask him, well, why do you break when he's doing a long fast? Why do you break your fast? And his reply to at least when we talked the other day was, because he's practicing the mucus diet healing system. He's not practicing never eat again. You know, he's not practicing I'm going to drink, only live on liquids for the next 10 years. He's practicing the mucusless diet healing system. So you work the system. And that is a primary message that I always hope to get over to people, is deal with the system. And if you don't understand what the system is, then ask. You know, I kind of assume when I say some of those things that people have some sense of what I'm talking about, or they're able to read the book or go to the resources and say, okay, well, this is what he's talking about when he says the system. It's about the system. And so, you know, Brother Air, he was about 10 years into the diet when he started a 4-year stint of peanut butter and jelly on toast, period. You know, he had this hardcore period. He's still practicing the diet, still going through all that, but he had that period of where he was eating, that, you know, that kind of thing. And so all these, and then when he came out of that period, once he stopped eating it, he never went back to it again. And soon after that is when he started doing the longer fasting periods, and he did a year on fruit, and he was doing, you know, sort of 100-day fast, you know, all this kind of stuff. That's 20 years in, 20 plus years into the mucus diet healing system, and that's when he's doing things that some people are trying to do within their second or third year, or think that they're supposed to be able to do, or they're looking in the mirror, why he's doing all this fasting, why can't I fast? I would love to be able to figure out a magic solution to get you to understand the importance of this transition. Because it's all I talk about. I'd say it over and over and over again. How can I get you to understand the importance of dealing with the system and the transition, yet be able to share the stories of people like Brother Air, or even some of my own stories of doing things that I would not suggest any of you do if you've not been into the diet for more than 10 years. You know, how can we have that type of conversation and communication? Because I want to continue to be able to bring Brother Air out here and have these conversations and really get into, okay, well, what are you doing now? What'd you do before? But how can we do that and have people understand that, you know, he's been doing this thing for 35 years, and a lot of the things that, you know, people get so fixated on, you know, long fasting or fruit periods or dry fasting. And I'll take some of the, you know, some of the brunt of like, well, you know, that was something, you know, maybe I could have put out more stuff about the early part of the transition. I tried to, you know, and stuff, but, like Brother Air might say, you know, some of those things, you don't think about it years later until it comes up, until someone really asks you about it. People always ask me, well, what am I eating right now? But I rarely get the question, well, what did you eat when you had started your transition? Even though I have published stuff about that. But to me, that would be a better question. It's like, well, how long did you eat a certain mucus lean mode? Or what kind of vegetarian meals did you eat, and how long did you eat them for, and, you know, and what do you still eat some of them, and, you know, those kind of questions would let me know that, okay, people aren't worrying about trying to live up to some sort of level. You know, I hear that sometimes where people say, like, man, I'm just, you know, I want to really try to get on you and Brother Ayer's level. It's like, what, you know, it's not about levels. You know, there's not a hierarchy of levels, and that, you know, I mean, it's, I mean, it's flattering that folks, you know, look at what I'm, at least what I'm doing, and find value in it, and are like, wow, you know, that's something but what I'm saying is, you know, your situation is going to be real different from mine, because your physiology is different. Your life situation is different. All these dynamics. So if you are going to take anything from me and learn anything, it's just that understand that this is a very customizable type of unique system, where what I hope I can help you do is gain an understanding and perspective of the foundation of this information, of the Mucus-free diet, of the principles. But at the end of the day, you have to be the one that says, okay, this, like, you have all this information, and then you just start living your life. You just go with it. Get out of your head. Stop. Don't be obsessing all the time about what you're going to eat or trying to live up to this image and all that kind of stuff. Because that's not what it's about. You know, it really is about, gratitude, you know, showing, you know, it's just being happy that you have this opportunity to breathe, to be out in the sun, to spend time with your family, and pursue physiological liberation. So, in closing, I want to thank all of you for tuning in, and you know, hope you get a little something out of some of these videos, and, you know, I enjoy making them, and you know, don't be hard on yourself. Look in the mirror today, you know, say I love you. You know, me and Brother Aaron would talk about, you know, we hate cliches, you know, we don't like, but sometimes they're just, that's what you have. I mean, and I understand that sometimes that has to be said. For us, it's almost, there's certain things that we think should go unsaid. And sometimes the self-esteem topic is something like that, where where there can be an attitude of like, ah, well, just get that together, just, you know, that's your response or something. But, you know, that's what I'm trying to really understand that better and say, okay, wait a minute, let's focus on this and see if we can help people that are looking in the mirror and not being happy with what they see. It's deep. You know, it's a deep. Like I said at the beginning, you got to have a balance. I'm not saying to, you know, it's not about being going soft and saying, okay, well, I can just be, you know, I can just, you know, where you don't care, you know, it's like, I just eat what I want. I do, you know, it's like, it's not that. Because Mucus's diet will always be as a healing system, is always going to be a cut above that sort of standard American diet veganism, you know, where it's just, it's more of a mentality thing than an eating thing. Because you could be practicing Mucus's diet and you might be eating some of the same stuff that a vegan is eating, you know, someone that identifies as a vegan. But again, you're coming from a different place and you will probably have a different understanding, first and foremost, of just the existence of the pus and mucus forming foods and the difference and why mucus is something that you want to restrict. But it's just a different thing. And but you should be able to look in the mirror and just, your first, that love should be there. You know, don't be looking and kind of, you know, over judging yourself and like, oh, I look at me. You know, it's like, nah, just start off with, I'm good enough. You know, I don't know how to not do the cliche, but, and even I've been reading today I sat down and I read several articles about overcoming self-esteem and sort of that kind of thing. And so much of what was in those articles were things that I already say or said. The thing in one article, when they said the things to do to overcome it, it was the things that I had already been saying, even in the video yesterday. You know, find things that you're passionate about and do it. If you need to talk to people, get, you know, go to counselors. You know, you start to reconstruct the core limiting belief. And the belief system of self hatred, you know, and low self esteem, you know, there, you know, and so, yeah. So now we know, you know, this is an issue, and what I would like for you to do is to help me out and everybody else out. If you're somebody who used to suffer from self esteem issues, what I would like for you to do is maybe share your story down below in the comment section, either, you know, the blog comment section or the YouTube comment section, wherever you're at, and share your story, and that'll help me better understand, I think, where folks are coming from when they're struggling with that, and, you know, some of the things that you did to overcome it. Maybe you took a course or you worked with somebody or something. You know, feel free to just share your story. Or maybe you're working through it right now. You know, and if you feel comfortable sharing your thoughts on it, feel free to do that. So I'm just trying to start the conversation. I don't have all the, you know, I definitely don't have all the answers. But I know it is an issue and I want to see people really gain the confidence and love for themselves that they deserve to have. So I thank you for tuning in. Until next time, peace, love, and breath.